Who's scruffy looking?
All right. Welcome to today's edition of Skywalking Through Film School. I am Danny. And to start off, pre-production has begun on Star Wars Theory's Vader fan web series with episode numero uno. The question always is coming up, how can we make something so huge for so little?
Whoa, dream big!
And that's what I want to talk about today, the ability to think big even when your budget may be small.
Judge me by my size, do you?
So today we're going to look at my second film from film school. And if you haven't seen my first one, definitely check it out. The link is below in the video description.
You're welcome!
In this second video, it came from a simple idea of a murder. But I wanted to take it a step further. And so I asked myself the question, who is the worst person in the world that can get murdered? Well, I got a poli-sci degree, so I went with the President of the United States. So I asked myself the second question, who is the worst person in the entire universe to kill the President of the United States?
Are you gonna eat your tots?
No, not him. Not him either. The Vice President of the United States, especially if there is a national crisis going on during that time. I had to make this film for less than $300.
What?
Shoot it in 2 days.
What? Say what again?
I needed a helicopter.
Say what again? I dare you.
So I had to utilize a lot of old school cinematic tricks to get this done and call in a lot of favors.
You think I'm cheap? How could you say that to me?
Remember, most important of any story you ever do is the story. So think of your best film ideas and then think, how can I up the ante and the stakes in my story?
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
And if you ever have any questions about how can I pull this off, look to the internet. Feel free to ask me. Ask other experienced filmmakers. And there's always a method and a way to pull off what you have in mind.
That's impossible, even for a computer.
Hope you enjoy it. Oh, and don't do anything I wouldn't do twice. Carry on.
He's not dead. He's in critical condition.
Truman, I could not have possibly done this.
We're the only two in the room with him.
I have something called somnambulism. I sleepwalk.
Just checking in, sir. Are you all right? Sir? Sir?
President's down. I repeat, code red.
Mr. Goodluck, are you all right?
Could you have done something and not known it?
Mr. Goodluck, can you hear me?
I don't know.
We need a medical team immediately. Send backup. Code red.
Just joining us, Vice President Anderson has been taken into custody for the attempted murder of the president. Many are calling for Speaker of the House, Jay Goodliffe, to become the acting president because of his close ties with Russia.
Jay would become president? You're the Attorney General. Can't you defend me on this?
Your right handprints are all over the murder weapon. Your somnambulism may be a great defense. But Russia is mobilizing its military. We just lost all 9 of our Supreme Court justices. We may not even have a Washington to land in soon.
We have just received confirmed reports that President Lee has died. Our President Lee has died. The Vice President is in custody right now.
I'll prepare the case against your impeachment. If you think it's best for the country.
Everything's good on my end. You ready to be the next president?
I want those clothes. Come on, Stone Knight. You gotta think about this.
Truman. You said that we were the only two in the room?
Yes, that's right.
You said that my right hand's prints were on the murder weapon.
Yes.
But I'm left-handed.
You were sleepwalking, Mr. Vice President. I represent Vice President Anderson. Take him to solitary confinement. He's to receive no visitors.
I didn't do it. I didn't do it! You're not gonna get away with this!
Mr. Goodliffe, sir. Your brother has just taken the oath of office and has nominated you as his vice president. You're now under the protection of the Secret Service. Can you come with me, please?